One night, a few years ago, I was sitting around at home with two of my girlfriends, and they were talking about their fathers. And since my own father died when I was 15 months old, I really couldn't relate. And at the end of the evening, I went up to my office to... It's just tea, you know. To check my mail. And I found an envelope on the desk. And when I opened it, I couldn't believe what I saw. It was a letter written by my father more than 60 years before to a woman he was dating when he was 19 years old, before he met my mother. And this very nice woman thought I should have it. I can't quite describe the feeling. It was as if my father was somehow trying to communicate something. It was a profound experience for me. Mystical. Papa, can you hear me? Papa, can you see me? Papa, can you find me in the night? Papa, are you near me? Papa, can you hear me? Papa, can you help me not be frightened? Looking at the skies, I seem to see a million eyes. Which ones are yours? Where are you now that yesterday has waved goodbye and closed its doors? That night is so much darker. The wind is so much colder. The world I see is so much bigger now that I'm alone. How I love you. Papa, how I need you. Papa, how I miss you. Kissing. I was making Yentl, I felt that my father was a guiding force, my protector in so many ways, you know. There were many times when he did come to my rescue. One late afternoon on the Irish Seas, we were filming the end of the movie. There were 20-foot waves. 200 extras were seasick. And a helicopter was bobbing 4 feet above my head. The playback system decides to go out. My stand-in had to hold a boombox underneath the camera so I could have something to sing to. We're at the end of the day. I've got to get the shot. We're losing the light, and there's nothing without the light. So I just closed my eyes and I prayed to God and my Father to let the setting sun be enough light to illuminate this next song.
Mission.